This is the Sneetches by Dr. Seuss. Now the star belly Sneetches had bellies with stars, and the plain belly Sneetches had none upon ours. Stars weren't big, they were really so small, you would think such a thing wouldn't matter at all. Because they had stars on the star belly Sneetches would brag, were the best kind of Sneetch on the beaches. With scoops in the air, they would skip and they'd snort. Well, nothing to do with the plain belly sort. Whenever they met some, when they were out walking, they'd hike right on past them without even talking. When star belly children went out to play ball, could a plain belly get in the game? Not at all. You only could play if your bellies had stars, and the plain belly children had none upon ours. When star belly teachers had frankfurter roast, or picnics, or parties, or marshmallow toast, they never invited the plain belly teachers. They left them out cold in the dark of the beaches. They kept them away, never let them come near, and that's how they treated them year after year. Then one day it seems all the plain belly teachers were moping and doping along on the beaches. Sitting there wishing their bellies had stars, a stranger zipped up in the strangest of cars. My friends, he announced in a voice clear and keen, my name is Sylvester McMonkey McMean. I've heard of your troubles and I've heard you're unhappy, but I can fix that, I'm the fix-it-up chappy. I've come here to help you and I have what you need. My prices are low when I work at great speed, and my work is 100% guaranteed. Then quickly Sylvester McMonkey McBean put together a very peculiar machine, and he said, you want stars like the star belly Sneetches? My friends, you can have them for $3 each. Pay me your money and hop right aboard. So they clambered inside and the big machine roared. It clonked and it bonked and it jerked and it burked and it bopped them about, but the thing really worked. When the plane star Sneetches popped out, they had stars. They actually did, they had stars upon ours. Yelled at the ones who read the stars at the start, we're exactly like you, you can't tell us apart. We're all just the same now, you snooty old smarties, and we can go to your frankfurter parties. The Greeks are the ones who read the stars at the first, we're still the best teachers, and they are the worst. But now how in the world will we know of which kind is what, or the other way around? Then up came McBean with a very sly wink, and he said, things are not quite as bad as you think. So you don't know who to, that is perfectly true, but come with me, friends, do you know what I'll do? I'll make you again the best Sneetches on the beaches, then all it will cost you is $10 each. Belly stars are no longer in style, to McBean. What you need is a trip through my star office machine. This wondrous contraption will stop your stars, so you won't let the teachers who have them upon ours. And the painting machine, working very precisely, removed all the stars from their tummies quite nicely. The suits in the air they paraded about, and they opened their beaks and they let out a shout. Now we know who is who, now there isn't a doubt. The best kind of Sneetches are the Sneetches without. And of course, though the stars got frightfully mad, to be wearing a star now is frightfully bad. And of course, old Sylvester McMonkey McBean invited them to a star machine. And of course, from then on, you can probably guess, things got into a horrible mess. All the rest of that day on the wild green beaches, the pink it up chappy kept fixing up the Sneetches. Off again, on again, in again, out again, through the machines they raced round about again. Changing their stars every minute or two, they kept paying money and they kept running through. Until neither the plane nor the star bellies knew whether this one was that one or this one was who. Then when every last cent of the money was spent, the fix-it-up chappy packed up and he went. And he laughed as he drove in his car up the beach, they never will learn that you can't teach a Sneetch. So McBean was quite wrong, and was happy to say that the Sneetches got really quite smart on that day. That day they decided that Sneetches are Sneetches, and no kind of Sneetch is the best on the beach. That day all the Sneetches forgot about stars, whether they had one or not upon ours. The end.